This video will look at four example problems of linear and exponential functions. First example, an Apple iPad in 2016 costs $730. Assume the value of the iPad will decrease at a rate of 26.5% per year. Write a model to express V, the value of the iPad in terms of, I should say, Y, the number of years since 2016. All right, so this function, it tells us it's decreasing at a certain percentage rate. That tells us it's going to be an exponential function. So we know it's decreasing by 26.5% each year, and it starts at $730. So the value of the iPad based on the years it's been is going to be equal to its initial value, which is 730, times 1 minus that decay rate written as a decimal. So that'll be 1 minus 0.265 raised to the y. And I'm just going to type in this equation so we can use it. I'm going to label the year and then the value. So putting in the equation just so we can use it to solve some problems. So equals 730 times 1 minus 0.265 raised to, and then the y. So just typing this equation in so it is usable. All right, so the next one says, if the trend continues, when will an iPad be worth half of the original value? Well, our original value was $730, so we need to see what is half of $730. So if I take 730 and divide it by 2, we see that we want it to be equal to 365. But that 365 is the value, so that's what we want to be in this equation, or in this cell, but this cell has our equation in it. So what we're going to have to do is goal seek this value to 365 by changing the year, and that will tell us when the iPad will be worth half of its original value. So to goal seek, I'm going to start by clicking in that cell with the equation, then data, what if analysis, goal seek. I want to set that equation to 365 because that's half of the original value by changing the year cell. Click OK twice, and it tells us that after 2.25 years, the iPad will be worth half of its original value. And on the test, actually tell me that it will be worth half in 2.25 years. I want to see it to two decimal places. If you round it to the nearest year, you will not get full credit because then I don't know if you solved the equation correctly and fully. So please always leave your answers to two decimal places. All right, next example. Benjamin started a weight loss program. After a week, his weight was 200.4 pounds. After 4 weeks, he weighed 193.2 pounds. Assume his weight decreases as a linear function of the number of weeks since the beginning of the program. So determine the linear equation that expresses W, Benjamin's weight, in terms of T, the number of weeks since he started his weight loss program. All right, so this one, it tells us that it's a linear function, meaning he's losing the same amount each week. And we are given 2 points here. We're told after his first year, or after his first week, he weighs 200.4 pounds. So that's our first pair of points. And then the second one is after 4 weeks, he weighs 193.2 pounds. And you could do this equation by hand if you wanted to. I prefer to use Excel. So I'm going to put in the weeks and then his weight. So we've got after 1 week, he weighs 200.4. After 4 weeks, he weighs 193.2. And I'm going to let Excel get this equation for me. So I'm going to highlight my data, insert a scatter plot with just the dots. Just so it's a proper graph, I'm going to change the layout to layout one. So I can title this weeks, weight, and this is Benjamin weight loss. And then I always click on that series one and hit delete on my keyboard because we don't need it. And remember, sometimes when you just have 2 points, Excel graphs them funny, but just looking at our points, it tells us after 1 week, he weighed 200.4, and after 4 weeks, it's 193.2. So that graph looks correct. So to get our linear equation, I'm going to right-click on one of the points, add trend line. I want the linear one, and I want it to display equation, and we can display R squared. So this equation is, see, putting it in terms of the right variables, it tells us that his weight, in terms of the number of weeks, is going to be negative 2.4 times the number of weeks, or weeks of T, plus 202.8. So breaking this down, we want to see what is the practical meaning of the slope, in context. So our slope is negative 2.4. So what this tells us, let me get a text box so I can do some typing. What this is telling us is that each week, Benjamin loses 2.4 pounds. And that 202.8 is the initial value. So when he started the program, he weighed 202.8 pounds. So that tells us the meaning of our slope and our initial value. It didn't ask for it, but we might as well throw it in there anyways, in context of the problem. All right, another example. In 2017, there are approximately 50 million students in kindergarten through 12th grade in the U.S. Currently, 20 million of them learn computer coding at school. According to a Gallup poll, the percent of students learning computer coding at school is increasing 25% per year. We want to write a model to express S, the number of students who are in coding in school, in terms of T, the number of years since 2017. And then we have a couple questions with that. So this is another one where they tell us our initial value, which is the 20 million students learning coding, and then they tell us we're increasing 25% per year. So because we're changing by a percentage, this again is an exponential function. So the number of students learning coding, which we're told to use S and T, is going to be equal to our initial value of 20 million times 1, since we're increasing, will be plus 0.25 raised to the T, where our T is years since 2017. So putting this in, we have our years and then our students. Our equation is 20 times 1 plus 0.25 raised to the, and I'm going to cell reference that years spot. So the first one says, according to your model, when will there be 40 million students learning computer coding at school? Well, we're trying to figure out the value, or we know we want the value to equal 40. We're trying to figure out when will that happen. So we're trying to look for years, and we know what our output's going to be. So this is a goal C question. We want to see, when does this equation get up to 40,000 students learning coding? So I'm going to click on that equation, go up to data, what if analysis, goal seek. We want to change it to 40 by changing our input cell. So we see in the year 3.11, if you round it to two decimal places, we will have 40 million students learning coding. And again, especially with goal seek, always round your answer to two decimal places. So you could say that it will be 3.11 years since 2017. That would be a good acceptable answer. I guess if you wanted to do it 2020.11, that would be fine as well, but I need to see the two decimal places to know that you did the goal seek correctly. All right, so the second part says, how many students will learn coding at school in 2020? Well, 2020 is a year. We can just plug that in. So let me drag down my equation so we have a space to work. That way I'm not overwriting the work I've already done. See, 2020, we're looking at years since 2017, so that's 3 years later. So we can just put in a 3 for the years. It'll plug it into our equation and tell us in the year 2020, we will have 39.06 million students learning coding at school. All right, we've got one more in this video. So the Gallup organization conducts a standard of living survey each year in the U.S. In 2009, 125.8 million Americans felt their standard of living was improving, and this number increased each year by approximately 10.3 million Americans. Write a model to express A, the number of Americans in millions who felt their standard of living was improving, as a function of T, the year since 2009. All right, so this one we're given our initial value of 125.8 million, and we're told we're increasing by a number, that 10.3 million Americans. So this is a linear function. So it's going to be A of T is equal to our slope, which is how much we increase or decrease each year, which is 10.3 T, and then plus the initial value of 125.8. Let's put this in. So we've got our years and then the number of Americans. So our model is equals 10.3 times the years plus 125.8. That way we've got an equation to work with. So the next one says, if this trend continues, in what year will 150 million Americans feel that their standard of living is improving? Well, this is telling us the number of Americans. We're trying to figure out what year did that happen. This is a goal seek. So we need to click on the equation, data, What if analysis, goal seek. We want to set our equation to the value 150 by changing the years. So we see 2.35 years later, 150 million Americans will feel that their standard of living is improving. And again, always leave your answer to two decimal places. Then for the second part, let me drag this equation down so we have a place to work. It says, according to your model, how many Americans felt their standard of living was improving in 2014? Well, we're measuring time since 2009. So 2009 to 2014 is what, 5 years later? So we've got 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, yeah, 5 years later. So if we put 5 in for the years, it tells us that in 2014, 177.3 million Americans felt that their standard of living was improving.